Okay, we're gonna show the same thing we did the Thomas Maupin basic buck step in leather shoes. I did mention that buck dancers almost always use taps unless they're in a contest and they have rules that say you can't wear taps. Then they are forced to wear leather soles or something. But the reason buck dancers like tap shoes is the that weighted toe makes you do these tiny little movements almost effortlessly. You can double and triple sounds and move a little bit to the side and do ticka 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 like without much movement. It's really hard in leather. It's certainly hard to get the volume. So that means your leather shoes, if you're going to buck dance, have to have a heavy weighted toe, or they won't get the sound there. So two and two sound, three sound, and four sound buck steps here, basic steps. I'm going to do them and do a crossover. Move it, Bon Jovi. Move it. Move it. Move it. So, and one. Don't forget that your downbeat is always on the fully weighted foot. It's not your one. It's never an upbeat. Never, never, never. These little notes that are like, sorry, not notes, but sounds that are and a one. That's why it's helpful to say that beat count out loud. And a one, and a two, and a three, and a four. Your downbeat is the full weighted planted foot. It's so monotonous looking if you just stand still and do that, but that's really, if you're in a dancing with a band and they just want a little rhythm section, that's actually all you really need to do. And you add the heel in, one and a one, two, three, one and a four. A chug. But you can also just nuance it. You kind of get your weight so it's half between both feet and then you switch. That's like nuancing your weight shift. And when you're dancing in Tennessee Valley Fiddler's Convention, you can't do a chug or you're getting disqualified. So you have to kind of like nuance the shift of weight. So the crossover, you also nuance yourself over so that one foot becomes in front of the other. And you do your and, of course, it's easier to do your and in the back foot. It's harder to do your downbeat in the back because it's just the way it's physically hard to do. So just, unless you're very flexible, your and a one. So your downbeat foot is in front. Always rotate when you're doing these. And your back heel's up. Usually the dancer's got their hands up when they're doing this. This is that buck dancer style. It's a little more flashy than the... I'm making that up, but I think that there's a little more of a up. Like flatfooters don't usually use their arms much. Buck dance is kind of like, you see Thomas Maupin raise his hands. So they're a little more like tap dancers. So that's what they are. Southern rural Appalachian tap dancers. So, once again, crossing over, it's going to be your same set, your same step. I just want to point out also that the ball that you start with can be up front right next to the other foot. I tend to like it in the back because it can take weight a little more easily. But you should try it anywhere. right next to the other weight bearing foot. Little bit of music. This is Mac Trinum. Come and last, come on very fast. Come on tripping through the plains. My speakers are dying here. Alright. Let's see. I think that was. I could put another. Let's try another song and then we can edit it on the YouTube editor. You know what I was interested in doing some Ellen